synonymous with martial arts, right? I mean, people look at this symbol, they think martial arts. A lot of martial arts places had it. And yes, it means balance, because we have a circle divided into two, and then this part has a part of this, and this part has a part of this. Okay. So that creates a balance. You never have, in reality or in the world, if something is completely 100% one side, what happens?
Off balance.
Disaster.
Disaster, yeah. Basically, it means death. Okay, if you go into some more deeper meanings, it means death. That's why there's a part of the yang in the yin, and there's a part of the yin in the yang. So they're basically two parts of the same thing. There is male, and then there's female, so maybe erased it. And then there's active, passive, hard and soft, effort, inertia, external, internal, aggressive, responsive, left brain, which is logic, reasoning, and right brain, which is creativity and emotions, things like that. So these days, when you watch martial arts or you watch fights and stuff like that, and TV, what do you mostly see?
Yang.
A lot of yang, right? A lot of aggression, a lot of violence, a lot of like becoming stronger, tougher, harder, faster. Okay? Now, what's wrong with that?
That leads to death?
If it's too much of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay? So what needs to happen? You need to balance it out.
More yin.
Right? You can do the same thing with any kind of conflict you have. You can deal with conflicts this way, and it works. What happens if you use too much of it? You become the bully.
Yeah.
You become the bad guy. Right? You don't have to fight. You don't have to beat the other guy, be stronger than the other guy all the time, outwardly. You can, what about this side? Do these things solve problems too? Being passive. Does being passive solve problems?
Absolutely.
Did Gandhi solve a lot of problems? Did he fight? No. He probably one of the most influential people in history. He didn't fight at all. He used this side. And he was able to change the whole country, right? Softness. Using inertia, momentum, instead of using effort. Okay? Internal. Being responsive instead of aggressive. Okay? And using creativity, using feelings, using emotion, using compassion to solve problems rather than just using force and using aggression. Okay? So as a martial arts school, we need to remember that we're not always focusing on just being stronger, tougher, faster, bigger, meaner. Okay, which is why a lot of TV, a lot of sports events like that, right? And it does serve its purpose at sometimes. You can use it, but also remember that there's another part of yin, that the female side, okay, the feminine side of it, that will balance your life, and that will balance your fighting even, okay, take you to an even higher level in your martial arts, in your personal development. All right, so that's yin and yang. Cool?
Cool.
Any questions? Any comments? Yeah.
And then I just want to add to that, correct me if I'm wrong, but eventually you want to know how to move between the two, because every situation requires either one or both.
Right. Yeah, I'm not saying one's better, but right now, most of what you see TV is just one side.
Yeah.
You don't see much of this side, of the yin. Okay? So yes, you can use yang, but remember, there's another side. We need to learn how to use both and balance it.
Well, is in martial arts the whole idea of not wanting to fight, to defend, rather?
Well, whole martial art is this, is
yeah.
Being able to do both. Being able to balance yourself so that you can be adept and doing both. You can be aggressive when you need to, but you can be passive when you need to, depending on the situation, to adapt. Adapt to whatever situation comes.
And sometimes the yang is really obvious and the yin is hard to see,
right?
But it's all in the techniques.
Right.
To make your yang and your hard energy better, you need the soft flow in between.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So when we start martial arts, we learn the techniques, we learn how to develop power. We have, a lot of us learn yang. We have to learn with the yang way because our brains and then society is kind of geared towards that. So a lot of people can't learn the yin way. It's very difficult, okay? So we teach the yang way, and then over time, the yin starts to sink in. Okay, the female, the feminine starts to sink in. The softness, the using the momentum instead of force starts to sink in. As more, it takes a longer time. It's like marinating something that you're cooking, okay?
and you can't just microwave it. You gotta take time to cultivate it.
Okay.
So, I'm Instructor Young at Combative Wing Chun, and we'll see you soon in our next video.